Welcome to today's video. I am here with Tim, and you can see that the Lexus is sitting way over there because she is now the star of today's show. Today we have Tim's Tacoma, which has made many appearances on the channel here before, but today we will have a walk around, a tour. He'll show you a little bit, I'll show you a little bit, and he will be editing this video, so make sure to comment, let him know how good of a job he did.
Like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe.
For more Tacoma content.
You heard him, I didn't say it. To get started here, I'll show you a little bit around the outside of the truck. I'll show you inside afterwards, under the engine bay, pretty much anything and everything that you can imagine to see with this truck. It's a 2022 Toyota Tacoma. It is a TRD Sport 4x4. It has the 6-cylinder engine, 3.5 liter, and it has a 6-speed automatic transmission. Now, this is not just a bone stock TRD Sport, Tim. What packages did it come with?
Came with the LED light package, so we got LED lights in the truck bed. We got a navigation package as well as the blackout decal package. So, and a bunch of mods, and we'll point those out as we go along of what is not stock.
So we'll get it started up, show around a bit on the outside, and then show you what all there is to see. Let's get into it. Here's the key. Unlock. Lock. Toyota badge on the back. Tim's little TRD keychain right there, so we'll get it open, get inside. Capacitive touch right here, so you grab it. It'll unlock for you. Go ahead, hop inside. Toyota steering wheel, obviously, right in front of you. Put your foot on the brake, push engine start, stop. And the V6 fires right up. We'll get started on the outside. Pop the hood, hazard lights, headlights. Now that we're on the outside, we'll go ahead, pop the hood. There she is. Powering this truck right here is the 2GR FKS engine. It is a 3.5 liter V6 engine. It puts out 278 horsepower and 265 foot-pounds of torque. You can hear it running right now. Now, as you can see, there are some hood struts holding it up. And Tim, would you like to tell us a little bit about those?
Yeah, those were a pain to put up. So if you want to see us struggle with that, Michael will add that to the end of the video. Go ahead and check that out.
So yeah, make sure to check on that one because that was a fun one to do. Bit of a learning process, but they went in pretty easily. They pop in right there, and there you go. So nothing too special here underneath the hood. Battery, fan, engine, fuse box, cooling system, washer fluid. It's about what you'd expect. Nothing too special that stands out underneath here. You can see right here, I can't put my finger anywhere back here because when you close the hood, you'll see there's a hood scoop. But as I couldn't put my hands in it, it is completely fake. There is nothing to see underneath there. Kind of cracks me up that Toyota chose that, but it's certainly one way to make the truck look more aggressive. On the topic of making the truck look more aggressive, we have 4 Raptor-style lights in the grill right there. Tim, would you like to tell us a little bit about those?
Yeah, we added those. Video at the end of this one again. Go check it out. Super, super easy to put in, and I love them.
Gives the truck a much more unique look coming down the road. They were actually surprisingly easy to put in, like you mentioned. Little fuse tap under the hood that we ran into it, but I did make a video on that, so throw that in at the end here. And yeah, there you go. As well as that, you can see that with the LED package comes these LED headlights. Camera doesn't pick it up super well, but I like the blinkers on those. You can see they start at one side, move their way down to the other. Does give it that more aggressive look right there, and they're definitely my favorite style of Tacoma headlights.
Also on the hood is a bug deflector. That came with the truck, so I didn't ask for that. They just put it on. Very minimal paint chips at this point, just looking at 25,000 miles on the truck, so pretty happy with that.
So LED fog lights, LED headlights, LED blinkers. Definitely a standout look to me. Last thing I forgot to mention here, this Toyota badge in the middle, as you can see, I reflect from the whole thing around. So that is the sensor for adaptive cruise control. It's also the sensor for forward collision warning and all that good fun stuff. While up front, I figured I'd mention as well, it does have disc brakes up front, and then it's got the good old drum brakes in the back in 2022 and through the end of 2023.
Not stock.
Can't forget as well the little TRD end caps there. Not stock. There's one of the many blackout emblems that Tim was talking about. You see Tacoma all in matte black there. You say that was stock or you added that on?
Stock. Well, that was part of the package.
So part of the package that comes with it. You see that you have blinkers in the mirror up here as well. So that's definitely nice. Let the guys next to you know that you're turning. Like I said, capacitive touch on the door handles if I want to lock it as well. There you go. Unlock. Simple as that. So here's the side profile of the truck. So down here is another non-stock element. Tim, you want to tell us about that as well?
Just some running boards from NFAB. Pretty low profile design. Like them. Didn't want a full running board, so those are the ones I went with.
And as you can see, they feel nice and sturdy here. They don't rock, they don't creak. Pretty much exactly what you want. Something stable to step on. Here by the back doors, nothing really too special. Just big rectangular sized rear door. Moving around to the bed. As you can see here, gas cap, bumper sticker, window sticker, I guess here. TRD 4x4 Sport logo. Mud flaps down here by the wheels, they're stock. Moving back towards the bed, we have a little step down right here. If I can get it, there we go. Step here, you grow a foot and a half taller. Kicks right back up into there. Blinkers are still on right now, so you can see the top of the taillights are the blinkers. As we go into the bed, you can see Washington caps, go caps. Tacoma, also in all black.
That was not stock, that I added, so there was no black out on the logo. It was just an impression in, so added that.
V6 is blacked out, that is stock. Hershey Bears as well, go Bears, go caps, Bears by a million, let's go Bears. But a little Toyota handle right here. Seems to have locked itself, so I'll pull out the key in a second and unlock it. But trailer hitch right there. I don't know what the tow capacity is. I'll look that up and throw it in here. But opening the bed, see your backup camera mounted right there. Key slot. Soft open tailgate. Makes it nice. Low, no loud clunking. LEDs on the inside as well. It's part of the LED package. Nothing much to see in here. Tim's just got some stuff stowed away. You do have a receptacle in here. I believe this is a 400 watt outlet. Yes, sir, it is. A little bit of storage right here. And just some tie-down hooks in there. Little storage cubby right there. Wheel dent impressions. Nothing too fancy. More utilitarian than anything.
Bed cover came with the truck. Just simple two latches. One, two. And then it folds right up. And I have taken it off all the way and then put it back on, hauling a TV. And it wasn't too difficult, so.
Aside from that, nothing too special going on back here. You got your little lights for your trailer hitch receiver down there, but outside of that, that's about everything to see back here. I do believe up there as well that those lights right above that little shark fin antenna are lights that can shine down into the bed. Third brake light. Yeah, that's about it. The passenger side doesn't really do too much besides mock the other side, minus the gas cap. You've got an exhaust tailpipe right down there, and that's about the only difference. It's pretty much exactly the same. Same running board, same design, same blacked out badges, blinkers in the mirror. But yeah. There she is. I'm gonna go ahead and move inside now. Go ahead and unlock it. Hop into the driver's seat. Starting up here, you have your visors. Typical visors, they pop off. They can, I'm gonna bonk myself in the face doing this. There we go. You move them side to side, in and out. Mirror mounted on top, open it up. There's LEDs that you can see that Tim swapped into there. You can see as well up here, you have a glasses holder. Nothing inside. LEDs, SOS button, and then same kind of visor on the passenger side. Here in the center console, button stack here, we have the most important button in the car. Like I said, engine start, stop, you push your foot down on the brake as you can see, push the button, and she boots up. Now, of course, every time that you start up the truck, you read that very important warning right there that tells you not to look at the screen or else you'll crash and die. You've some different functions here. You got your home screen, menu, there we go, audio, map, seek buttons, track buttons, phone, apps, but back to menu. Destination, audio, phone, apps, projection, just kind of the same old thing. This does have Apple CarPlay capability, which is nice. Sirius XM capability, you've got your volume, your tune down at the bottom. We've got climate control screens below that, just a little screen right here. Turn up the temperature, turn down the temperature, sync, different modes, fan speeds, all that good stuff. Some little indicator lights right there for anti-theft, for airbag control and all that. And then your hazard lights, which I also showed you earlier. See this little nub right here? It looks like nothing right there until you go ahead and throw a phone on it and go ahead and stick to it. Nice little add-on right there. Not stock, obviously. Four-wheel drive selector sits right below that. You have your mirror defrosters, and then climate controls, like I mentioned. Underneath of all that I just showed you, you have a little 12-volt cigarette lighter, power outlet, whatever you want to call it. You have your little button right there for this wireless charging pad that sits below it. You can go ahead and throw your phone on it. It charges. USB port right there. You have your button right there that activates this little bad boy. Pretty sweet. You have your poverty buttons right there, as I like to call them, because they remind you of features that you don't have. Or since it's a Toyota, it's probably just a blank switch that there's nothing there even if you get the highest trim level. You have your ECT power button for extra transmission power. And then another little blank switch right there. Nothing much sitting right there. Cup holders right here. You have your shifter right here. Of course, it's the Toyota one, so it shifts weird. Reverse is out and down. It likes to beep at you, especially if the door is open. Neutral, drive, and then manual selection of gears. Up and down, and I'm going to put that back into park because it's beeping at me because I have the door open, and it does not like that. Now that I have the door closed, I'll put it into reverse. You can see there's a backup camera right there. Nice little feature to have, of course. Put that back into park. E-brake, parking brake, whatever you want to call it, sits right here. Go ahead, lift it up, put it back down. It'll hold the truck in place, make sure it doesn't roll away and hit anything or anybody. Cup holders sit right down here. They've got these little push tabs in right here just to make sure that your drinks don't go anywhere. And then you have a cup holder and a little storage space up here right next to your leg. Behind all of that sits the center console. Underneath the center console lids, it's a little tray that Tim picked up from Amazon. Go ahead, pick that up, and then you'll see nice and spacious in there as well. It has a USB-C port and a USB-A port down there, so plenty of spaces for charging. Two down there, and then one in there, so nothing to complain about there. Also can hold a pen right there. Utilitarian, who doesn't love it? Down here, highlighting my shoes that are dying to be replaced, I think they're something like 10 years old now, are these blue running lights that Tim installed. Did they change colors or are they just blue?
Bottom blue.
So we bought them in blue. So as you can see, door opens and closes. It'll make them brighter, dimmer. Doors are closed now. They are off, or at least dimmer than I can't see.
Very dim.
Yeah, very, very dim. But nice little accent, lights it up, makes it look cooler. There you go. Floor mats below me are the Tacoma floor mats. They came stock with the truck as well. Looking at the dash and then up above it, you can see right here sits a little, what's it, Nexar camera?
Nexar. Got about a year ago. Just keeping track of the morons on the road.
And I'm sure you've caught plenty of them.
Yeah, of myself and others.
We don't worry about that first part. But you can see right here sits the steering wheel. Volume up, volume down. Screen selection buttons right there. Or no,
that's
music
bad.
Track selection.
Yep.
Yeah, I knew that. This is for the screen over here. See all the different options that you have right here. Going back to the start, we have speedometer, distance to empty, fuel economy, trip distance, time until rest, or just the blank screen. To change that as well, so you have your compass, music
also,
selection.
On the compass, if you have maps up on the display, it will show you next turn.
Which is a nice feature to have, of course. Bluetooth audio, tire pressure, any hazards messages, and then just good old settings. So you have that there. Those are the top buttons. This one right here
allows you to select a favorite for that. So every time you turn on the truck, it'll pop up with whichever one you pick.
There you go. Forward collision warning, distance setting, lane departure assist. You have your call, start, and end, and then mode or mute button for your radio. You have your tachometer on this side. You have your engine temperature gauge as well. You have your fuel gauge. You have your speedometer. And then screen in the middle. And this dial right here can also adjust brightness, which is, of course, a nice setting to have because you don't want it blinding you at night. You have your wipers doing a little happy dance right here because you have your wiper stalk right here. You can set it to all the way high, low, intermittent, or off. And then hit it once for mist, of course. Bring it in and hit the washers if you need to. Clean up that windshield nice and good. Cruise control sits down here, also spins around with the steering wheel. Of course, you have your horn in the center. Nice. Left, right, fog light switch right here, on, off. You have daytime running light off, auto, daytime running lights, and then you have your actual regular headlights. It does have automatic high beams, so I'll put it back into auto like it was before. You can see that underneath this vent right here is the off button for traction control.
Dude, you have a friggin' jellyfish launcher on your truck, dude? What?
You have your bed lights here. Turn them on, turn them off, set it right there. You have your auto high beams button right there. Now it's off, now it's on, and then that is for the 400 watt inverter in the bed. I'll go ahead and turn it off. Engine is now off, dash cam is now off. And Tim, would you like to tell them about that lovely beeping noise that you're hearing?
That is probably my least favorite thing about this truck. If you have the door open before you turn off the truck, it will do that until you close the door.
And that is whether or not you have the key in it.
Correct.
So it's just reminding you, your door's open. Don't forget it. Moving more towards the outside, you see a nice little textured piece right there. You have two automatic windows right here. Push them down, pull them up all the way, and that's automatic. The back ones are not automatic. You have your lock button, you have your unlock button, power mirror adjustments there. Speaker in the door. Stock weather floor mounts, like I said. Power adjustable seat. I believe it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 way. So, makes for a nice and comfortable seating position. Aside from that, I believe that that's everything in the front, minus that little door jamb right there, but we'll move on to the back seat here. Here we have the back seat. There's no capacitive touch right here, so you can't lock or unlock it unless you have the key in your hand, obviously. Go ahead, pull it open, and you'll have the back seat where I've spent plenty of time driving up to Hershey Bears hockey games. Right here, kind of same deal as before. It's got this little textured piece right here, door handle, window switch, little handle to pull open and pull closed, two cup holders and a bit of storage down here, and another speaker. When you get around to this way, you have another all-weather floor mat, which is nice to have. You have the back seats right here. It's a bench seat in the back. No pockets on this side. Two more cup holders right here. The back seat also lifts up, where you can see that Tim has his first aid kit stored, because you never know when you'll need that. Onto the other side, the passenger side here. Back seat. You pop open the door. Same kind of deal here. Nothing too special over here. You have a map pocket on this side, which distinguishes it from the other side, kind of for the driver to be able to reach over there, grab whatever he needs from in here. Nice and spacious in there. Tim's gonna pop open the other side right there. It pops open just like the other one. Lifts up there, and then you have a storage compartment underneath. So you look inside, it does pass through. There's a bit of a tunnel cut out right there so that you can actually fit the drive shaft back, but you've got some spare tire equipment in there. Go ahead, close it, lock it. As you can see, pull this back for even more storage. So there's more storage back there. You got a good old Ryobi battery sitting back there. The driver's side back seat does this as well. You see that we have it folded down right here, but you see the flat storage compartment right there. It's nice to have. Load up your toolboxes, your tools, whatever you don't want in the bed, whatever you want locked in the security of the cab right there. Other things that I didn't mention, you see this little handle right up there. You see there are a couple hooks right up there, little trees. Tim, who I locked out of the truck, and then this light up here, which I don't have on right now, is also LED, but that covers just about everything in the back. Sitting here in the back seat now, you can see there's a decent bit of leg room. My feet get caught a little bit underneath of there. My knees are probably about an inch and a half from here. A lot of people complain that these trucks aren't very accommodating for tall people. I'm not super tall. I'm about 5'7", so to give you some perspective there, that's where I sit. If I move over to the middle seat here, which once again I have sat in before, that little hump cramps you up just a little bit. Same deal with the passenger side here. Some space, not really a ton. If you're going to be hauling around anybody really taller than my height, it's probably not going to be optimal for you. And then my head sits, I don't know, 2 inches, 3 inches from the top. Most of my height's in my legs, but there's wherever he went. There he is. But yeah. It's not too bad back here. I've spent a lot of time in these seats, and it's nothing too uncomfortable, but it gets the job done. Moving into the driver's side, I did show that off a little bit. Capacitive touch here, so you can unlock the door right there. This seat is not power, manual backrest, no lumbar adjustments, and then manual slide forward, slide back. It does have an all-weather floor mat, which is stock as well, as you can see by the big Tacoma badge there. Tacoma written on the door right here. Same deal with this door, nothing too special, just your individual automatic window control, lock, unlock, door handle, manual lock, and then a couple cup holders down there as well. You have your vents right here. Your vents right here, you sit inside. Definitely more space up here compared to the back. Thank you, Tim. You have your glove box right here, nothing too special. Just kind of pop it open, throw your storage in there. It's kind of a double decker, so you can throw your manual down there and everything else up top. Pretty spacious. You have a grab handle right here, your visor right here, also swapped out to LED lights. You can see my phone, which as I show off in every video is horribly cracked. Close that, lift that up. That's about all there is to see here. Outside of that, that is about all that I have in store for this video. Just kind of wanted to give a brief walk around tour. We've showed off the truck enough times, we figured we'd actually get some content on what all we're working with. So, hope you all enjoyed that. If you did, please be sure to like, subscribe, stick around for more. Drop a comment, let us know what more you're looking for. I'll put the other Tacoma videos at the end of this video. Kind of link them below. Go ahead, check those out. Plenty of interesting content to see there. Unless Tim has anything to say, that is about all that I have.
Thanks for watching.
Yes, sir. Thank you for watching. Enjoy, plenty more to come.